many of y'all ready to have church tonight? Isn't it good to be in the place that God created? Even though we might not be in the house of the Lord, we know that we're the house of the Lord. And it's so good to be out here with y'all. And from the time I got up this morning, I was so excited about this service because I know God is going to do some great and mighty things. And I felt Him give me this verse before I came. If I can get it out. This drama, as everybody's getting in their places for prepare, I'm just going to testify a little bit about what God's done in my life. It's been so amazing. And I'm thankful for what He's done for me when I didn't deserve it. And I want to thank the Lord for what He's doing in our church. And I want to thank Him for always sending a messenger at the right time. And something that He did in the Old Testament, I wrote the verses down. It's in Malachi 3:1. The Lord said, "Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to the temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight. And behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts." And then in Isaiah 40, verse 3, "And the voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." And all this time, God is, He's sending forth a word through the prophet saying, "I'm going to send a messenger who says, prepare ye the way of the Lord." And we all know that that's John the Baptist. And when he came in Matthew 3, verses 1 through 3 says, "In these days came John the Baptist, preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Yeah. For this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of the one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight." And then, well, it doesn't stop there, because Jesus said in Matthew 28:18-20, he says, "And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the world." And that's what God has assigned us to do, is to prepare the way, because His kingdom is at hand. And if you don't know the Lord, you need to come and find Him before it's too late, because God is doing some great and mighty things, and He wants to bless you. He wants to love on you and encourage you. And I'm telling you that there are young people who are on fire for God, and they don't care what their peers say. They don't care what everyone around them says. They just want to see God. And I've become one of those people a few years ago, and there's no turning back for me. And I want all of you all to know that I love you, and most of all, that Jesus loved you so much that He died on an old rugged cross so that we could all be saved. And I hope that you find Him tonight if you don't know Him. And if you do know Him and you need to rekindle that fire in your life, make a point to do that, because the time is at hand.
God is good, ain't He?
Yeah. Yes, He is, Casey.
I tell you what, He's faithful regardless of what we go through. And I thank Him for saving me and for delivering me from what He's done. It's not always been easy. Just because He saves you does not mean you're not going to fall on your face. And I have struggled for a couple weeks, and God knows that. And I also know that He's going to bring me through it for something greater.
Yeah.
And that is exactly why that I struggle. That's why we face challenges. But I was reading the other day, and well, actually it was along with preaching, and it wasn't even what He was preaching. And it was over here, and a verse just stuck out to me in John 14:18, and it said, "I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you." And that was exactly what I needed to hear at that point. And it doesn't matter what you've done in your life, it don't matter what you've failed at, even if you're a Christian. It doesn't matter if you fall. I heard something the other day that said when you run a race, if you fall in mid-course, you don't get up and go back to where you started from.
Right.
You just get up and you dust yourself off and you keep going. And that's exactly what you do when God saves you. If you fall, you just dust yourself off and go on. He'll pick you right back up.
Right.
But I pray that each and every one, if you don't know this Jesus that we're talking about, He's waiting on you. He's right there. If you've known Him and you've turned your back or you feel like you've gone too far, it doesn't matter. He's right there waiting on you, and you're still here for a reason. And I believe that you're at this service tonight for a reason. Just open up to Him.
Amen.
Prepare.
as the praise team comes up, I just want to share something really quick. Jeremiah 17:9 says, "The heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can understand it?" That scripture has been rolling over in my spirit all week. And I think God is calling us to a generation and to a church who is not going to get caught up in the things that the flesh desires, that they're not going to get caught up in the things that their hearts desires, but they're going to purpose in their hearts that they're going to look to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and they're going to seek after Him, and they're going to run after Him.
Yeah.
Tonight, we're getting ready to go into praise and worship, and I just want to ask you all to stand to your feet. I know it's hot, but we have a Savior who went to an old rugged cross and gave His best for us. The least we can do is worship Him. So everybody stand to your feet and just bow your head, and we're going to say a quick word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You for this time together. We thank You for this experience tonight, God. I pray, Lord, that as we go through this night, that Your Spirit fall in this place, that we can look to You and that we can seek You and that we can run after You and that we can lift You up, and in return that Your presence fall and that lives be changed and that seeds be planted. We just ask that Your word and that Your will be done in this place. It's in Your Son's holy name that I pray. Amen.
Like a so that we can hear better with each other. Ashamed. You know, in the Bible it says, if you will be ashamed of him, he will be ashamed of you. You know, we are still just like, I can't remember who it was that was saying it the other night, about, it was Eric in youth service. He was talking about us being the church. You know, you think of church being a building, but it's not the building. We are the church.
Right.
We have Jesus Christ living inside of us, and we are the church. And so we need to be able to worship God freely and let these people know that are living without hope, that there's hope for them tonight.
Oh.
And we have found it. And so we are here to praise the Lord and give him all the praise that he deserves tonight.
What a turn into wine.
for a few minutes, and we're going to ask Rick Hope to come right now, and he's going to bring forth a message. Everyone give him a hand clap. Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Good to be here tonight, ain't it?
Yes.
Good to know Jesus, ain't it?
Yes.
Oh, it feels like it's 100 degrees, but that's all right, ain't it?
Right.
Yes. I'm going to be reading from the book of Mark. Before I start, God, I come to you right now, Lord.
Yes.
I am nothing. I need your anointing. God, I need you to speak to people, Lord. I thank you for the confirmation that this is the message that you've got for us tonight. Lord, just rain your Holy Spirit down upon us, Lord, as we get in here, saying it's been good to sit in this sun and get a little closer to the Lord, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, and they brought young children to him that he should touch them. His disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up in his arms, put his hand upon them and blessed them. And when he was gone forth into the way, there came one running and kneeling to him and asking him, good master, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life? Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one. That is God.
Right.
Thou knowest the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not kill, do not steal, do not bear false witness. Defraud not, honor thy father and mother. And he answered and said unto him, master, all these have I observed from my youth. Then Jesus, beholding him, loved him, said unto him, one thing thou lackest, go thy way, sell whatsoever thou hast, give to the poor. Thou shalt have treasure in heaven. And come, take up the cross and follow me. And he was sad at that saying and went away grieved, for he had great possessions. Jesus looked about and said unto his disciples, how hardly shall they that have riches enter into the kingdom of God? The disciples were astonished at these words. But Jesus answered again and said unto them, children, how hard is it for them to trust in riches to enter into the kingdom of God? I want to ask that same question that guy asked Jesus. What do I need to do?
Come on, Rick.
That I can have eternal life.
Come on.
Oh, that's a question. You know, I went to Food City the other day with the simple task of going down there and getting some chili. And when I got to the place where the chili was, I found out they was aging chili. They was chili with beans. They was Van Camp chili. They was chili with no beans. They was hot chili. They was mild chili. They was big chili. They was little chili. So what's the right thing to do? What's the right kind of chili to get? Now, if you woke up this morning and you knew nothing about God, you turn on your TV, the first thing you're going to hear is, what is the right religion? What is the right way to go? What is the right way? God's going to cut it down some for you tonight.
Come on.
And tell you exactly and specifically what you must do to inherit eternal life. The first way he's going to cut it down. See, this guy got a lot of stuff right. The story didn't end exactly the way it was supposed to. But he got a lot of stuff right. The first thing you need to understand is some people will tell you, just be sincere. It don't matter what you believe in. Just be sincere. It don't matter there's many roads to heaven. Just be sincere. Just get behind somebody and be sincere. Whether it be Muslim, whether it be Islam, whether it be Buddha, whatever the case may be, just as long as you're sincere, there's many roads to heaven. That's a lie from the pits of hell. That's a lie from the pits of hell.
That's right.
The Bible says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by Jesus.
Yeah.
So get that out of your mind. The one thing this guy got right is he ran to the right person.
Come on.
I said he ran to Jesus. He ran to Jesus, which seems to indicate a sense of urgency. And let me tell you something, young people. When you get into times of depression or times you don't understand, there is one guy you can run to. His name is Jesus. You don't have to run to the local bar. You don't have to run to drugs. You don't have to run to alcohol. You don't have to run to nobody else. You don't have to run to the psychiatrist. You don't have to run. There's one place you can run to. His name is Jesus Christ. And when you're in trouble, when you're in doubt, when you don't understand, when there's stuff going wrong in your life, you need to run to Jesus and nothing else.
Yeah.
He is the greatest power in the universe. When you run to him, he will take care of you. So this guy got a lot of things right. He ran to Jesus. But the thing that confused this man is he heard Jesus dealing with these kids. He seen Jesus loving these kids, and then he heard that statement. No man, the kingdom of God is as a child coming to his father. No man can enter into the kingdom of God unless he does as a little child. So here he is, an old man or a young man, whatever the case may be. But he's wondering, how can I get into the kingdom of God as a little child? It's a matter of your spirit that you're in. You got to get rid of your pride. You got to get rid of everything. And you got to say, God, you have the answers, and I don't have the answers. You give them to me. Run to Jesus. When you got something, if that's one thing that God wants to get to you. He is our source of everything we need. He is the source of life. He is the source of health. He is the source of salvation. There's only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus. And he ran and he kneeled to Jesus. You will not get to heaven without kneeling to Jesus. And let me take away your excuses here. You know, a lot of people say, well, there's hypocrites in the church. There's hypocrites in this church. There's hypocrites in that church. Don't let the hypocrites keep you from church. Don't let the hypocrites keep you from God. Don't let the hypocrites keep you from you having that experience with God. There is a true blue experience with God. And when you really come to an altar, it will alter your life. And you won't drink no more. And you won't do drugs no more. And you won't bet on the ball games no more. And you won't go to the bars no more. When you truly come to an altar, it alters your life in such a way that the Bible speaks about you will be born again. So don't let the hypocrites, and I apologize for the hypocrites, I really do, but let me tell you something, I'd rather go to church with them than to go to hell with them.
Come on.
I said I'd rather go to church with them than to go to hell with them. Because let me tell you something. There's a God that knows the thoughts before you think it. There's a God that knows what you're thinking about. There's a God that knows what you're going to do. There's a God that sees in the hidden places. There's a God that hears when you think nobody else hears. And I apologize for the hypocrites. But let me tell you something. You're going to stand before God. And you're going to stand there by yourself. And there ain't going to be no excuse. Yeah, they are hypocrites, but let me tell you something. There's some true brood Christians sitting right next to you, too.
That's right.
There's some true brood Christians that you can call. 3 o'clock in the morning, they'll be there. There's a true blue experience with God that you can have tonight. There's a true blue experience. Just because people don't live like it's real, don't mean it's not real. There's some true blue. The only reason there's a counterfeit is because there is a real.
That's right.
If they ain't no real, there'll never be no counterfeit.
Come on.
Get the real thing tonight. Get the real thing tonight. Get the real thing tonight. You will stand before God and you will give an account of only your life. You won't give account of what sister so-and-so did or brother so-and-so said. You will give account of your life.
That's right.
You will stand before God. And Eric, I want to appreciate you obeying the Lord that gave me the confirmation that this was the word that God wants. This is this guy's problem. He's going through life pushing his cart. And the only thing he's concerned about is his great possessions.
That's right.
Is his great possessions. And he's going through life just looking for what he can put in his cart. Can I put a little bit more money in there today? No, I get you. You stand there. Can I get just a little bit more money today? What about a new car? Can I get a new car today? Well, can I make some profit today? Can I make some money today? This guy was a business dealer. And he comes to Jesus and he said, I want to make a deal with you, Lord. I'm going to do a good thing and you're going to give me eternal life. He's not interested in serving God. He's interested in the reward that comes from serving God. He just wants to have eternal life so he can put it in his cart. He don't want to change nothing. He don't want to agree nothing. And that's what Eric was talking about. Don't get caught up in the things that the world will offer, in the things that you can possess, because your life does not consist, let me get in the shade a little bit, your life does not consist in the things that you'll possess. Your life consists in Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Yeah.
Amen.
So he's going day by day, filling up his cart. But there's one thing that he is running out of a supply on, and he don't know what to do about it. It is one thing that you are running out of a supply on. And God's going to tell you what to do about it. He's running out of the supply of time. When this day goes by, you got one less day to live.
That's right.
When this day goes by, it's gone. And you're one day closer to heaven, or you're one day closer to hell.
Come on.
And there's nothing you can do to buy it back. Time's ticking. And I wish it would stop, Barb. I wish it'd start. Stop. I wish it'd stop while the kids are still young. I wish it would stop. I saw so many times I wanted to stop. But it keeps on going one day at a time. And before you know it, they're 8. And before you know it, they're 18. And it's like, where did the time go by? Let me tell you, there's one thing you're running out of today. And that is time. But he recognized that I got a way I can buy a lot of time. If I can just figure out what to do, I can have eternal life.
Yeah.
I can have all my possessions. I can have my cars. I can have my houses. I can have my bank account. I can have my big job. I can have all this stuff and still have eternal life. See, some people think we can have eternal life without changing our life. But let me tell you something. God went to a rugged cross. He sent his son to a rugged cross.
Yeah.
To save us. To save us from our souls. To save our souls. To give us eternal life. You have to change. You have to change. And a change has to be so much that you can't do it by yourself. Some religions actually preach, just pull over another leaf. Just start doing better. Just do the best you can. But you will not go to heaven doing the best you can. This guy had kept all of the commandments from his youth up, yet he knew that he lacked one thing. Let me tell you something. You've got to have Jesus. You can't pave your way to heaven. You've got to have Jesus. You can't be good enough to go to heaven. You've got to have the blood applied to your life. You've got to kneel. You've got to run. You've got to pray to Jesus. You can't make yourself better. You can't make yourself good enough. Only God can make you good enough to get into his heaven. And it's for family members. And you get family because you get the same blood. And when the blood of Jesus is applied to your life, you have eternal life. But this is the key, young people. What my help, y'all? Opens here. This is the key. First time he said something. Hold this for me, Lord. He said, you got to come to Jesus. It's a little child. This is almost looks like a little child, don't it? Left him in my car today. Praise somebody go bust my window out thinking I left the car, baby in the car and at 95 degrees. See, this baby has no opinion. This baby is in my arms and I am its master. I can take it anywhere. I can do anything I want to do with it. Is Jesus your master?
Wow.
Is Jesus your master? Are you in the arms of Jesus like a little child? See, we make salvation so complicated. You got to do A, B, C, and D. Then you got to do 1, 2, and 3. But let me tell you something, what you got to do. You got to come to God just like a little child with no opinion. Just like a little child that'll crawl up to you, hold his arms out, and say, Dad, Dad, give me. Dad, Dad, I'm feeling bad. Dad, Dad, that's what we've complicated the issue. But all you got to do is say, Dad, Dad, I messed up. Dad, Dad, I need a Savior. Dad, Dad, I need you. When you come to Jesus as a little child, he accepts you in his arms. And then he puts you in his cart. Okay, you get the picture here?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Logan. Push it around just about 10 feet or so. He gets you in his cart. And he pushes you where he wants you to go. Okay, Logan, stop right there. Just stay right there. He pushes you to where you want to go. And what that means is you are no longer worshiping and concerned about your possessions, but you are worshiping and concerned about the one who possesses you. You have turned into getting possessions to being a possession. And that's what you are concerned about. How can I please God? What can I do to go with God? What can I do the will of God? When you get in his cart, he's going to give you, he's going to put things in there for you, whatever you need. He is our provider. He will give you what you need. My God shall supply. I said he shall supply. I said he shall supply. All. I said all. Not 90% of it. I said God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. It's time we got in his cart. Let me tell you, young people, let me tell you, old people, whatever's hearing this voice, there's only one way you're going to make it through this earth. Times are bad. We're getting things passed that shouldn't be passed. Our country's going crazy, and everybody's passing this and passing that. And if you offend me, I'll take you to jail and get something done about it. Let me tell you something, there's one thing, and one way only you're going to make it, young people. Old people, that's if you be totally sold out to God. And just as a little child, say, God, I belong to you. You take me, you push me, you be my master, I'll lead. And let me tell you something, pushing around a little bit, Logan, he's going to push some of you. I said he's going to push some of you to be teachers. I said he's going to push some of you to be lawyers. I said he's going to push some of you to be doctors. I'm looking at some evangelists right in front of my eyes. He's going to push some of you. Some of you are going to travel all around the world because God's going to do the pushing. And you're going to wonder, how did I do this? How did I do that? How did this happen? Let me tell you something. When God guides, God provides. And it's going to do some great things for you. Just let him push your cart. You get your stuff out of the cart. And you get in the cart and say, God, I belong to you. And all my possessions belong to you. I'm a sold out child of yours. And I'm not going to worship my possessions, but I'm going to worship the one who possesses me. Let me tell you, that's the key to salvation. You set it all and say, God, it belongs to me. I may live in the house 60 years, but it still belongs to you, Lord. I may work for the money, but it still belongs to you, Lord. I belong to you, Lord. And just push me wherever you want me to go. And you watch God do something that's going to amaze you. You watch God do something. No matter what it pushes you into, You're in full-time ministry.
Come on.
You may be a teacher. You may be a doctor. But you're in full-time ministry.
Right.
You're a full-time Christian. And God's going to push you where He wants you to be. And He's going to make a way where you think there's no way. And He's going to make rivers in the desert. And He's going to change the way you think. And He's going to change the way you act. And He's going to change the way you feel. Because all you got to do is run to Him tonight. It's your choice. It's your choice. See, this story had a bad ending. If y'all want to come to the music, you can. This story had a bad ending. Because what happened? The guy had great possessions. And he wasn't willing to trade his great possessions for eternal life. You say, well, I come to God when I quit doing this or when I quit doing that. You ain't never going to quit it till you come to God. That kind of thinking is like saying, as soon as I quit bleeding, I'll go to the ER.
Mom.
As soon as this arm fixes itself, I'll go to the ER. There ain't but one fixer. His name is Jesus Christ. And just like He looked at this man, and He loved this man, because He knew this man was sincere. This man wanted eternal life, but he knew how it was going to end up. He knew that he worshiped the things in his cart. What are you concerned about? They say we worship the first thing we think about of the morning and the last thing we think about of the night. That's what we're truly worshiping. What are we worshiping today? Am I asking myself, how am I going to get a little bit more money? How am I going to get this? How am I going to get that? As Eric so much put it, the lust of the flesh. How can I acquire this? Bill Petty Pizza's got this and I got to keep up with him. If I got to work 70 hours a week, I got to buy me a car just as good as him, because I got to be just as good as him. Let me tell you what you got to do tonight. You gotta say, Lord, all my desire, everything I got, I'm gonna love you with all my heart. I'm not gonna give my heart to my bank account. I'm not gonna give my heart to just finding a new house and a new car and a new boyfriend, a new girlfriend. I'm not gonna give my heart. Just like Eric said, it's amazing what he came up with. Don't follow your heart. It's deceitfully wicked above everything. I'm going to follow you with all my heart, Lord. Not 98% of it. With all my heart, I'm going to love you. And I'm going to love you with all my strength, Lord. When I'm tired, I'm going to love you. When I'm sick, I'm going to love you. When I don't understand, I'm going to love you. When I'm down and out, I'm going to love you. When I'm depressed, I'm going to love you. When I don't know what's going on, I'm going to love you. When I can't see my way out, I'm going to love you. I'm going to love you with all my mind, with all my strength, with all my heart, and with all my soul. I said, God said tonight, He's looking for people. That'll sell out. And if you'll sell out, God will push you places. And He'll push you into situations. And He'll make your life better. You see, Peter came on later. If I was to read some more, Peter came on and Peter said, Lord, wait a minute. We've done this. We've left our families. We've left our home. And we've came and followed you. What shall we receive? He looked at Peter and he'll say, if you leave anything for the kingdom of God, you will receive manifold more in this lifetime. I said manifold more in this lifetime. You want to make a good decision? Sell out and invest it in the kingdom of God. And say, God, you are mine. You will receive manifold more in this lifetime. And then in the life to come, life eternal. Oh, it's worth it. It's worth getting rid of that great possession. You may have a great addiction. You may have a great problem. You may have a great something that's keeping you from God tonight. But let me tell you, you can trade it. You can trade it in for eternal life tonight. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. Oh, God. Oh, God. The best I know how to do, I preach your word, God. The best I know how to do, Lord. And God, there's some people, and they want to wait until, and they want to wait until. But let me tell you, every day that comes by, you've lost another day that you could have been serving God. Every time the sun sets, you got one day less than what you had. And you're running out of it. You can't stop it. But there's a supply in heaven. There's a supply of life in heaven. There's eternal life where 1,000 years won't seem like a day. And 10,000 years won't seem like a minute. Let me tell you, the Bible says the sufferings of this present time are not to be compared to the glory that shall be revealed in us. So if you're suffering something today, just get through it. Get over it. Get on the other side of it. Because it will not be compared to the glory that awaits us in this beautiful heaven. Yeah. Let me work out some things, Lord. Let me work out some things, Lord. He gave that guy a choice. Don't sell it all. Come back. Take up your cross and follow me. Let me ask you a question. Are you following Jesus? I didn't ask you if you attended church. The devil goes to church every time the door is open. He comes early. He stays late. Didn't ask you if you attended church. Didn't ask you if your name was on some church membership. Didn't ask you if you give to the poor. Didn't ask you if you paid your tithes. Didn't ask you if you kept the commandments. One question and one question only. Are you following Jesus? Are you following Jesus? If you're not, you can start tonight. I said, Lord, I sell all my confusion. This one preaches this one preaches that one, this one preaches the other one. I sell all my excuses. I said before, if he's going to go to heaven, I'm going to heaven. I live better than him. I sell all my excuses tonight, Lord. I sell all my reasoning tonight, Lord. I sell it all. I trade it for a cross, and I'm going to follow you tonight, Lord. If that's you tonight, just come and stand. Just come and stand. Somebody will pray for you. If it's you, just come and stand. Just step out. Step out for Jesus, because he stepped out for you. Step out for Jesus in public, because he took the cross right through the business district of Jerusalem. He took the cross right through the rich man's, right through the poor man's backyard. On the cross, right through great possessions. And he said, if you want eternal life, come and follow me. Come on, while he's singing. Come on, while he's singing, you young people.
I give myself
away. Just give yourself away. Just give yourself away tonight. Say, Lord, you got it all. 100%.
I'm
gonna go. I come to you right now, Lord. And God, just like you looked at this man with love in your eyes, God, these people here that just couldn't completely say, Lord, I put myself in your cart. They couldn't say it tonight, Lord. But God, I pray that you will continue to look at them with love, Lord, and have patience with them, Lord. And God, just give them another chance, Lord. And God, just wake them up in the middle of the night. Just tell them how much you love them, Lord. Just let them know that you give them this beautiful day. Tomorrow is no promise, Lord. God, just keep looking at them with them eyes of love, Lord. Because they've not completely walked away. They're just in that valley of decision, Lord. And God, I pray that you will send somebody every day with the right words, Lord. And God, I pray that the people they look at, Lord, that you will help them to just be better, a better light to them, Lord. God, just keep on looking at them with eyes of love. Because your son came to the cross to die for them, Lord. God, they're good for people when they don't understand that the blood has to be applied. But God, I know you know how to introduce yourself to them, Lord. They could be driving down the street or working, Lord. We're in the middle of the night. Wake your spouse up and say, I want to give my heart to the Lord. God, don't quit looking at them. Because you're not slack concerning your promises, but you're long-suffering, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, Lord. And God, I thank you that the people hearing my voice, you're going to give them eternal life. They may not have did it tonight, but they will do it. You're going to plant a seed there, and somebody else is going to come by and water it. Somebody else is going to come by and water it. Just when they think it's dead, somebody else is going to come by and water it. Lord, I thank you that your word does not go out void, but it does accomplish what you sent it out to do. And you sent your word out to save those people that are hearing your voice tonight.
Yeah.
And it's not going to come back void. I claim every soul that's hearing this voice tonight for the kingdom of God's sake, they will be saved in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Get out of her mind. Get out of her ego. Get out of her spirit. She's just as good as anybody
I'm taking it down, but the joy of the Lord. I'm taking it down, but the joy of the Lord.
You know, God's word tells us that he's come back for a bride without a spot or a blemish. And I think the message that Rick preached tonight, that we can take it and we can apply it to the church. That we can start looking at ourselves and saying, are we completely sold out? Have we completely ran after the King of Kings and Lord of Lords? Revival is not a series of good services, but it's when the church starts looking at itself and saying, am I like the King of Kings? And it's when we start running after Him and we start looking after Him and we become more fully alive in Him and start becoming like the King that we serve. As we get ready to leave this place tonight, as we get ready to have service tomorrow at our own churches, let us go in with a heart that is purposed to praise Him, to worship Him, to get into His presence and allow Him to speak to us and to change us. Let's not leave this place and let the word fall on bad ground, but let's let the Lord plant a seed in our heart that we can start as this week goes on, as we have service, as if we have Monday, Tuesday, that we can start looking to the King of Kings, that we can start becoming more like Him. And as we get ready to leave tonight, I'm going to pull this out on Anna. I just feel like this is what the Lord's speaking to me. But as we leave tonight, can you all do, He set me free again, like you did Sunday.
Gary.
Yes.
I want to say a prayer, okay?
Hold on 1 second.
Amen to that. Lord, touch us.
We brought this out, and we haven't brought it out just for Cumberland Pentecostal Church. We're wanting to see this community blessed of God.
Amen.
And I want to see it blessed. I want this Tri-City area to be blessed of God. And as Rick preached tonight, and as he has preached, and you've heard the word of the Lord that has went forth. The thing of it is, you will be held accountable because you have heard true word tonight. And I just want to say a prayer tonight over our community and over the churches in our community that God tomorrow will, they will be just an upset in their services of those that are desiring to see a move of God, that they will begin to see it starting tomorrow.
Yes.
And I'm asking the Lord, this is not, I want to just not do this one time and that's it, but I want to keep continually doing this and us come out here. If it's just to do praise and worship and to sing, and some of you do your testimonies or whatever, but we're going to get the word out into this community, and that's what I want to do. So before they sing tonight, I want to just bow your heads and let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for Cumberland, Benham, and Lynch. I thank you for our community. I thank you, Lord, that you have planted us in this area. And God, I am believing that you're going to bless this area. It's going to be blessed. We're tired of the negativity. But God, we are going to be blessed in the name of Jesus. We're going to be blessed coming in and going out. We're going to be blessed, Lord. You're going to rise upon us, God. And I am believing, Father, that the glory of the Lord is going to shine upon this community once again. The Holy Ghost power of God is going to begin to rise up in this community. I pray for the mayors of this community. I pray for board members, for those council members, God, that they will come in unity and work in one accord, and these cities will begin to work together, and we'll begin to see a divine revival in this area. God, I am believing, God, you are going to send it. I pray for every church in this area. I pray for the pastors and their wives. I pray, God, the blessings of God upon their churches, and Lord, as they enter, that they will see deliverance begin to take place in the churches, God. I ask, God, in the name of Jesus, everyone that passed by here tonight, I pray, God, that when they lay down tonight, they'll hear Rick's voice. They'll hear, God, that you're calling them. And God, I am believing, Lord, all we can take to heaven is those that are not saved, and I want to get in all that I can. And God, I pray, Lord, you do it in the name of Jesus. And we give you praise for it, Lord, and glory, and thank you for it. Give Jesus a hand clap of praise.
I just want to thank the Lord that it doesn't matter where you've been, but whenever you give your heart to the Lord, that He changes you and you're not the same anymore. And that's why I really felt the Lord kind of lay this song on my heart last week. Because once like a bird in prison, I dwell. Every one of us, before we were saved, every one of us was black with sin. It didn't matter what we were doing, how bad it seemed to the world, but we were lost. And I want to thank God that we've been set free tonight. Once like a bird in prison,
for those of you that think that gospel music has gone too far, you think we've gotten too radical with our message, well, I got news for you. You ain't heard nothing yet, and if you don't know, now you know. Glory, glory. Woo! don't you hang it?
And the fullness of God made me thankful, pity to hateful, I'm grateful. The Lord brought me through this far. Trying to be cute when I praise him, way too high. I keep it live, be bumping, keep jumping, make the Lord feel something. Ain't no shame in my game, God's property. Couldn't be a curse, ain't no stopping me. That's something.